Greetings, this is Pastor Linda with the thought of the day. Today we're going to look at Luke 18. All right, we're going to zero in on that last scripture where it says, I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth? You know, just the fact that the Lord has to ask that question, is he going to find faith on the earth, is a very thought-provoking question. Is God going to find faith on the earth? So I could ask that question of you. Is God going to find faith in your life, in your family, in your home? Are you exercising your faith? Do you believe him? So he says, I tell him he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, shall he find faith on the earth. Notice he said, I will avenge them speedily. So God's going to take care of us speedily. That word for speedily means quickly. So God will avenge us. He will, and he has avenged us. He destroyed Satan and took away his power. But the question is, will he find faith on the earth? Do you believe him? The Bible says in Hebrews 11, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Are you walking in faith today? All right. The word for faith means conviction of the truth of anything, belief. In the New Testament, of conviction or belief respecting man's relationship to God and divine things, generally with the included idea of trust and holy fervor born of faith and joining with it. Here's another example of that same word, faith. When Jesus heard it, he marveled and said to them that followed, verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. So the thought of the day is today, will Jesus find faith on the earth? Will he find you in faith on the earth when he comes? That's the thought of the day. So until next time, this is Pastor Linda with Christian Family Church of Lakeville. Join us Sundays at 10 a.m. Go to cfclakeville.com. You can watch us online or you can come in person. We'd love to meet you. Also, check out my webinars and more thoughts of the day at lindacross.com. And don't forget to support the work that we're doing in establishing Bible schools and as the Lord provides around the world. So sow a seed so you can reap a harvest tomorrow and see God's kingdom established in the earth. Because our mission and our passion is to win souls, make disciples, and build the church. And you can be a part of that. God bless. Until next time, this is Pastor Linda with Christian Family Church saying, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you, look upon you with his favor, and give you peace today in Jesus' name. And say, I receive that. Amen. If you need prayer for anything, just email me at linda@lindacross.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great and awesome day. Hallelujah. Today is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. You are great and mighty God. All praise and honor and glory be unto you, O God. You are the author and the finish of our faith, Lord. Your kingdom come, your will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Your kingdom come, your will be done, Lord. Today in this place. Today, Lord, in our families, in the earth, in our church, in our children, our grandchildren, Lord. May your kingdom come, may your will be done. Our government, Lord, in our president and our vice president, Lord, in our judges, Supreme Court, Lord, representatives, senators, governors, mayors, Lord, may your kingdom come, may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. The devil, he has to flee in Jesus' name. Colossians says, you spoiled principalities and powers, and you made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it, Lord. For you are a great God, keeping covenant, Lord. Daniel 9:4. Deuteronomy 10:17, Lord, for you, Lord God, are God of gods and Lord of lords, the great God, mighty and awesome, who shows no partiality, nor takes a bribe. Lord, you are a great God. Deuteronomy 26 and verse 8. You brought Israel out of Egypt with your mighty hand, with an outstretched arm, your outstretched arm, with great terror, with signs and wonders, Lord. Nehemiah 9:32. You are a great and mighty God, awesome God, who keeps covenant and mercy, Lord. Thank you for the blood of the everlasting covenant, Lord. You are great and mighty. You keep covenant and mercy, God. Thank you for your mercy today. If it wasn't for your mercy, Lord, we'd be all consumed, God. Thank you for your great mercy, Lord, your great plan. That you sent your Son, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whoever believes in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Jesus, John 3:16. You are great, O Lord. You are mighty in power. Psalms 147, verse 5. Your understanding is infinite. Because you are omnipotent, omniscient, all-knowing, all-powerful God. In Jeremiah 33 and verse 3, call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. Lord, we look to you today. We call upon you, Lord. We know that you'll answer, God. You'll do great and mighty things that we don't even know today, for you're great and mighty. So have your way. Have your way, O God, have your way, O God, in my life, in my family, my children, our government, Lord, in the earth today, Lord. May you be glorified, O God, be glorified, O God, in the earth today. Your kingdom come, your will be done, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, O Lord. Thank you, Lord. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, Lord, those things, those sins, as we forgive those who've sinned against us, Lord. Forgive us, O God. Lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord, we thank you that your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Today in our lives, we pray. Jesus, be glorified in all that we do and all that we say today. In Jesus' name.